All right. Hello, everyone. A big thank you to you all for signing up and tuning in for today's webinar. My name is Patrick Qureshi, and I'm a Senior Program Manager here at Milestone Systems, and I will be moderating today's webinar. We have an exciting webinar planned for you today because we will be taking a closer look at how advanced video analytics can help transform your video data into actionable intelligence. We'll be looking at how the BriefCam solution works seamlessly with Milestone's video management system and share some typical use cases within retail, transportation, and smart city. And in case you're not from those industries or you have projects with customers from other industries, then fear not, because the scenarios you'll see today are just examples of how you can use this type of technology to make your video easily searchable, actionable, and quantifiable. Because the possibilities here really are endless. Don't worry about taking notes. We will be recording the session and we'll share the link with you afterwards. You're also very welcome to ask questions during the webinar. You can use the questions box in the GoToWebinar panel on your right-hand side. We will take the questions we have time for at the end. We do have quite a lot of content to go through, but so in case we don't get to your question, then we will respond to you after the webinar. All right, so let me introduce you to today's two speakers. We are joined by Warren Stein from BriefCam. Warren is the Vice President of Sales within EMEA and the APAC region. And Warren will be walking us through some of the possibilities with the BriefCam solution and with a focus of showing you the possibilities rather than just talking about them. So hope you will appreciate that. Then we have Haider Mohammed, who is Milestone's Community Manager for Middle East, Africa, and Turkey. Haider will be our first speaker. He'll give a quick intro to Milestone and our community, and we'll talk about how Milestone's VMS is built to take advantage of video analytics. Good, so let's get started. Let me hand you over to Haider. Haider, please tell us more.
Thank you. Thank you for the introduction, Patrick.
Go.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the webinar. I'd like to start off with giving a quick introduction of Milestone Systems. So if I have to put it in one sentence, Milestone Systems is the global number one video management platform that enables the hardware technologies and applications produced directly by Milestone or coming from our technology partners like BriefCam. A quick glance and overview of Milestone. We have more than 1,800 plus solution partners, one of which is obviously BriefCam, which comes up with the video content and video analytics, and that works seamlessly on our platform. We'll go through that later and during the webinar. We are very proud to say that we stand out in the industry today with having more than 10,000 plus camera integrated onto our video management platform coming from 170 plus manufacturers globally. Obviously, cameras as edge devices plays a very important role when we talk about the video management. A quick overview and a little bit of deep dive of what do we mean by Milestone Open Platform. If we can segment the end customer solution stack into three segments, we can see the bottom layer, which is the hardware layer. That's where our camera partners, our infrastructure partners that produces servers and storage systems, networks, IoT devices or sensors, those physical devices come into picture. And the top layer, which is the application layer, that's where the BriefCam application video analytics comes into play. And there could be other systems like access control system, building management, PSIM, traffic management, so on and so forth. Milestone Expertech platform sits in the middle layer. So what Milestone platform does is to couple these two layers together to offer a complete end user solution stack, couple these technologies coming from our technology partners like BriefCam or the hardware partners, couple them together to offer a complete end customer solution stack, offering them a complete solution that may resolve their pain points. Moving quickly into our community solutions. So Milestone is the open platform. That is something in our DNA since the inception of Milestone. It's the open platform that enables all our technology partners to work with us together and offering some unique solutions and bring some unique technology to our customers. We offer seamless integration to our customers, example of which, as you will see further in the webinar, is BriefCam, which offers video analytics. And other examples could be access control systems, building management, PSIM, automatic number plate recognition systems, and so on and so forth. Milestone platform offers open APIs. That's where our developer community comes into play. We have a global developer community that can develop unique customization to our software. Plus, they can also come up with some unique new features that may fit into requirements of the customer using our APIs. Last but not the least, the certification and validation of all these solutions. So that gives extra peace of mind to our users that they're using the application, they're using the integrations that are certified, that are validated by both parties. It's not something that is developed out there and they're just going to use it. It's fully validated, certified by Milestone. So that gives them extra peace of mind when using our products and technologies coming from our partners. The overall picture to show how Milestone platform operates. So Milestone platform sits pretty in the center, offering the video management capabilities to all the subsystems that work in parallel. It could be the edge devices like cameras, like microphones, body-worn cameras, onboard vehicles, and many other subsystems like RFID, one of which is obviously BriefCam, offering their video analytics. They work in parallel, and we bring these technologies together onto our platform to offer a complete solution for your requirements. With these, obviously, there are some important characteristics of the platform, which I like to talk about. When we talk about the subsystems and many, many other edge devices working together on our platform, obviously, there are a lot of compute that is required to manage these subsystems. We are very proud to say that we have one of the highest performing VMS in the industry today, reaching up to 3.1 gigabits of ingest rate coming from the video on a single recording server. So you can imagine you can have many, many devices, edge devices or cameras that can work on a recording server, thus reducing the hardware footprint and obviously reducing the total cost of ownership of the infrastructure. And there are like complementary technologies around this, so working with our platform like multi-stage archiving, SVQR, which is related to edge storage, multi-live streaming, unicast and multicast support in combination. We can talk about this more in detail. You're more than welcome to reach out to us later, and we can discuss all of these together in detail if you want to. But as you can see, all of these together can really reduce and optimize the whole solution, and thus bringing down the total cost of ownership of our solutions together. With all these subsystems, there's obviously a lot of data, video data that we're talking about. And with all these concerns around there in the industry today, the security of the data, we invest heavily into our platform security. And we take this something that is we take it very seriously. There's a lot of security perimeters that are built into the platform. There is a complete hardening guide that we offer to secure our platform. Just to name a few features that we have available by default in our platform are Kerberos user authentication, HTTPS communication, bidirectional encryption, password protection, digital signature, certificate-based encryption, and two-step verifications. So as you can see, there's a lot more focus on the security, making sure that we have a very secure platform with and all your data and coming from the subsystem, the video data is fully secured when working with our Milestone video management platform. Hardware acceleration is something very unique and something that we have launched and invested heavily on. So we work with NVIDIA and Intel GPUs. We have optimized our software code to make use of NVIDIA GPUs. This helps us saving a lot of CPU load. And thus, when you reduce load that is required for our application, we can use the extra CPU power for other applications like BriefCam and other systems that work on our platform. We also do parallel processing of these GPUs. So you can slot in multiple GPU cards and we can do load balancing and work with these GPUs and thus reducing a lot of hardware that is required to work with these applications on our platform. So in turn, we used with these GPUs and we reduced total cost of ownership. And you can imagine with all these computing power utilizing these GPUs, we can really reduce the total cost of ownership. And when I talk about these GPUs, these work with different components on our system. The smart client, which is our operator application that the operator uses to view the cameras and to manage the control room operations. We utilize GPU there for the video decoding, the recording servers, and as well as the mobile servers. Milestone Marketplace is something really exciting that we launched at the beginning of this year. Milestone Marketplace is the centralized knowledge hub, which bring the integrators and technology partners together. It's the hub, sort of a knowledge hub available on our website where you can experience a wide variety and range of verified hardware and application solutions that are available to complement Milestone software. You are more than welcome to go to our website, just search for Marketplace, and you can see a lot many solutions, including BriefCam, which is listed there, and you can learn a lot more on these solutions, how it works, how it installs onto our platform, and a lot more details. So that is just a bit of overview on how Milestone platform operates and what are the complementing technologies that are supporting our platform. I'd like to hand it over now to Warren, who will walk us through on BriefCam and how it is seamlessly integrated into Milestone and what are the different capabilities of BriefCam that adds value to a video that is managed by Milestone.
All right. So good late morning or good afternoon, depending where you all are. Thank you to the Milestone team for the wonderful introduction. And hopefully in the next few minutes, we'll be able to walk you through some of the wonderful collaboration we have with Milestone and what BriefCam can do for you together with Milestone. One second. All right. So on our agenda today, we're going to give a brief overview of the video surveillance ecosystem, look at BriefCam's approach to video analytics, look at BriefCam within a Milestone ExpertTech client, and I would like to spend most of our time sharing some examples within our application, so you can enjoy some of our capabilities. The big challenge today, and I've been in this industry for some 8.5 years now, and I'm not sure if it was pre-9/11 or post-9/11, but the world really went crazy. And today, the amount of cameras, some 350 million IP-based video surveillance cameras collecting data 24 hours a day, obviously this results in an enormous problem of just too much video being recorded. The amount is overwhelming, and obviously the investments are severely underutilized. With not enough eyes to be able to view the video, and the sheer scale makes it impossible to comprehend the video data. No doubt, many of you are fair with the video analytics market, and but I'm sure typically it's more on analytics for the edge device or point solutions, be it license plate recognition, face recognition, line crossing, perhaps, or people counting. But BriefCam's uniquely fuses our computer vision and deep learning technologies into a comprehensive video analytics platform And as I believe Patrick said earlier, we like to say we are making video searchable, quantifiable, and actionable, where different stakeholders in the organization can extract value from the video. It could be the investigator for post-event investigation, for quantitative analytics, analysis, and of course, real-time use, where we proactively can manage events as they unfold. Let's take a look at what we're doing. Is that in BriefCam, we take video, raw video from, for example, the VMS system, and we process the video once into our database. And BriefCam analyzes the entire content of the video and creates structured database of information out of the unstructured video. And then we present it in different presentation layers after we've processed it only once, and we can deliver it many times to different stakeholders, again, making the video searchable, quantifiable, and actionable. So how does it work? Is we essentially take an object, we detect, track, extract, classify, and catalog every object. Now, to the untrained eye, you can see a woman on a bicycle, but what BriefCam really knows is, because we are able to extract all the data and metadata, is we know that it's a woman on a bicycle wearing white upperwear of long sleeve jacket and a black long pants, riding at a certain speed, 10 miles per hour in a southerly direction. And we, 1 second, I think we have a bit of an issue, 1 second. Okay, we're back on live. So you can see we extract the full scene coverage, and we extract every object. And here you can see our woman riding over there, and we again have extracted all the metadata. BriefCam's video synopsis, patented video synopsis, is how the company was actually born. A very, very unique way of taking a long period of video, for example, 30 minutes, and by simultaneously presenting different objects at different times in the same place, we significantly reduce the time of actually viewing the recorded video, very, very important in investigations. And we could actually filter out more. We can go one step further with our smart synopsis and, for example, filter out only women wearing blue or bikes traveling in a certain direction, and this making our time to target even faster. BriefCam has been an integral part of Milestone Systems Expertech client, I think, for the better part of the last decade, and we continue to develop and have tighter integration. And what I'd like to do now for the next few minutes is to show you BriefCam within the Milestone Expertech client and walk you through some examples. All right, so many of you are already Milestone partners or users, are very familiar with the Expertech client. I'll just show you from the outset that if one wanted to start a new investigation, one can do it from within the Expertech client. We can start a case or add to an existing case. And this obviously is a good example of the deep integration, which continues to be fostered within Milestone and BriefCam. So let's jump into the BriefCam application. And I'll walk you through a few examples. So we have three modules: our review module for our search, respond module for our real time, and our research, which is a robust BI tool. What we can do with BriefCam, and I'm on the review module now, we can choose the source, we can choose a time range. We have many, many classes. We can choose a man, a woman, a child, two-wheelers, bicycles, motorcycles, different other type of vehicles, from pickup trucks to trains and even boats. We also have another capability which is quite important for recon, where one is looking for an object or person of interest, and we are able to detect when lights have been turned on and lights have been turned off. We have a host of person attributes where we can detect people wearing long sleeves or short sleeves and the colors. The same with the lower wear, long pants, short pants, skirts, etc., and the colors, with a hat, without a hat, with bags, without bags, etc. We can also detect different colors and a variety of colors from different other objects, non-person objects in the scene. Real world size, real-world speed, both in kilometers per hour, miles per hour, feet and meters. We're able to detect dwell time. So it's quite important when you're looking for people who are loitering, perhaps, so we can look for people who are dwelling for more than X or Y seconds. Similarly, inside the retail environment, that's quite important to see how long someone spent at a certain area. And direction, the direction of the particular scene, appearance, similarity, to look for objects which are similar to other objects in the scene. And we have a face recognition with inside BriefCam as well, which I know obviously is quite a contentious subject at the moment, but obviously we can help you with GDPR compliance. And it can also not be enabled. So this is quite important in today's world. So without further ado, let me jump into a few examples. So let's take a case here in City Plan. We're looking at a typical highway, and we are looking now at one particular camera with almost 4,000 objects in this particular camera. And what you're seeing now is typical video synopsis, where I've simultaneously presented different objects that occurred at different times in the same place. I've actually taken 1.5 hours worth of video, and I've synopsized that into under 8 minutes. But now I want to find an object of interest. I'm interested in finding for example, a green motorcycle. So I go into my class, I choose motorcycle, apply that, and instantaneously we can see, even before we see the video, that there are only 23 motorcycles. And how many green motorcycles there are is, in fact, only one. So we really found the needle in the haystack in just a matter of seconds. We double-click on that, we can get back to the original video, add that to our case report, and we're good to go. Let's reset that. Similarly, we could look for a certain vehicle, perhaps, which stopped on the side of the road. So we want to go into our dwell filter, and we will look for something which dwelled for more than 5 seconds. And in just two clicks, we see that in this particular video, in terms of cars, I mean, this is a bit of noise, but we found a car which stopped at 8:46 only on the side of the road. It was only one car. Here it says two because of the noise. I'll double click on that, get to the back to the original video, and then I can understand and make informed decisions about that. We can also, of course, go into our research module, which is our BI tool. I'll give this a couple of seconds just to launch, and we can choose different elements of traffic analysis. In this particular scene, it's intersection analysis. And we can slice and dice the data, which again was extracted, put into our database, processed once, and now we are presenting it in the presentation layer. Our research module is fully customizable, very, very easy to use, and we can again slice and dice the data. For example, if the bicycles were interesting to us, we click on the bicycles, and you can see that the charts are elastic and they change instantaneously, and this is a very, very powerful tool. Let's refresh that and go back to our cases for a second, and let's choose, for example, a case where we are looking for some type of traffic violation. So we can go into a particular video. This happens to be a video in China, where my understanding that that traffic signs are mere suggestions and they're not an absolute must, but anyway, we take a part. We want to find all the vehicles which are illegally turning, illegal U-turns, so we can choose that path, we apply that, and we should see that, by the way, in this period of time, 307 cars made illegal U-turns, which is in and of itself is quite an achievement. We could also decide to gather alerts on this particular traffic violation. So we hop into our respond module, which is our real-time module. We would have created a rule in the beginning. I won't do that now for time's sake. Go into our rules, and we'll see that illegal U-turns, the following events occurred, and we were alerted to these particular events. We then can go view in, we zoom in, get a close-up clip of the particular transgression, and we can then create a bookmark, and we can move on with our cases. All right. Let's hop into a different case now. more on the law enforcement or safe smart city use case, and we will look into our law enforcement. All right. So let's say we were looking for a perpetrator or some suspect, which, for example, was a man. So we look for a man using our classes. We apply that. We know that he was wearing a red long sleeve shirt or jacket. This is what we were told. So we take long sleeves and we choose the color red. We then know that he was wearing long trousers, which were blue. And he was wearing a hat. So we see now that out of all these videos, there were some 5,746 objects. And we want to find our suspects. And we narrow it down to just 8. We look at the time and we see the times are relevant. We then can get a close-up clip and we see the suspect, or whether it the suspect walking out of the store with a close-up clip. Again, we can add to our report and move on with our investigation. Very, very powerful. In the same vein, in the same city, we may have lost a child, lost a boy wearing a hat. So we choose a child. We apply that. We choose. We know that he was wearing a hat. And again, out of these some 5,700 objects, we narrow it down to 2. We know that 4:09 p.m. fits our description. We see that the child, in fact, yes, he was actually walking with his father, uncle, or at least someone. He was not by himself. We see that in the close-up clip. So this is also very, very powerful stuff. A different way to use BriefCam in the safe city environment, we could take a particular video. This actually happens to be a case. I think it's even been publicized by both Milestone and BriefCam in Hartford with Hartford Police, where they suspected that one of these houses was actually a drug house. They put in a surveillance camera, and instead of viewing a very, very boring, laborious, having someone look at the video all day long, they put a camera there, and in 12 hours, they were able to analyze the following in the following way. So they discounted all the cars because they weren't interested in the cars. They chose people, and they saw that there were obviously significant fewer people. And then they used BriefCam's visual layers. Used BriefCam's visual layers to look at the popular paths, where the people were headed. And it'll take just a couple of seconds to process that. But we can see that the lion's share of people actually were headed to this house. And for time's sake, I'm not going to draw the path, but suffice it to say, we know it was north of 240 people. In fact, 1,200 people entered that house within 12 hours. So they were able to crack down the crack house, and all's well that ends well. But obviously, BriefCam saved them a significant amount of time and resources in cracking down that particular area, and obviously making the neighborhood a little safer. To show you also another other capabilities of BriefCam, let me just hop into another case. We've already mentioned that face recognition is controversial, and it can be enabled or disabled. And obviously, I can't use real-world examples to demonstrate BriefCam, but I can use our office environment. So our very, very strong face recognition capabilities can be seen here. We choose face recognition. We show the faces. By the way, we obviously can have a watch list. Here we have a watch list called Office Suspects. We could stand on that. We could see these are the pictures that have been added to our watch list. Hop back into there. We choose a object of interest, and we go into our face recognition. We hide faces, and we can see that this particular individual appeared 4 times in this camera. 0 times in the dining hall camera, and in the entrance camera appeared once. We can then go into the detection, and we can see that BriefCam is showing you this particular individual. This is the picture versus the actual video that was recorded. Similarly, we could go into our respond module and obviously have a real-time alert for the same watch list. Example would be to go into the rules of the office suspects. We apply that. and we can see that these are the live alerts that we received from that particular watch list. When we go into the picture, we can see the video and the picture, and we can add that to our report and move on. So that takes us through to another use case in terms of our retail section. Just reset that. And we'll hop into another video. So in terms of retail, obviously, loss prevention is very, very important. This is just to show you a very brief capability of BriefCam post-event investigation. In this particular scene, we understood that a bottle of wine was stolen. So what we did, we knew that the wine was over here in this section of the shelves. We took an area of interest. We just wanted to see which events occurred within that area of interest. We applied that. And in just a few seconds, we see that that the suspect came in, and she very elegantly took a bottle of wine and placed it in her knapsack. And if we actually go into the original video here, you can see that she actually waits for the the store clerk to actually have his back turned. The store clerk is over here and was able to steal the wine without any shame. So that's for loss prevention. Let me just get out of this, reset that, and go back to our cases. Looking at consumer behavior, obviously this is something which is very relevant and very important for retail video analytics. So we could take, for example, a video here, and we could decide to only look at, focus on men. Similarly, we could focus on women or children, but we have the capability of doing it even with a fisheye camera, by the way. So this is obviously relevant in terms of counting people and segmenting the people who are entering the stores. But equally interesting is to see exactly where they went. And then we could use this example here with our visual layers in this particular video. We could, for example, look at the activity heat map. We see the activity in the store looks quite normal. We could look at the dwell heat map and understand where were people stopping more than other places. So just from observing this, I could say this area was particularly popular. This begs the question, I'm not so sure about this. And we could do a path map, which I've already shown you an example of, so I won't show you again. But what's equally interesting is also actually the object interaction. We can detect background changes, so we see which items are more popular than others, and this we can detect from the background changes in terms of those heat maps. These are obviously the people sitting, maybe some of the husbands waiting for the wives, I guess. So that is that's another example over there. Of course, this is very, very nice when one wants to look at maybe one day's worth of video or 4 hours worth of video. But when we want to aggregate the data and we want insights from the data, we obviously want to use our research module. We want to use the BI tool. So we hop over there and we find the relevant dashboard, which once again is fully customizable. And let me just find the right dashboard. Give me a second. So we see the analysis of the shoppers. Here we have an example of the heat maps, again, fully customizable. If you only want to focus on the woman, so I would choose women. I would then tick that. And we can see here just by ways of insights, we say, okay, so the women were very interested. Many, many women the shoes were quite popular, the bags were quite popular, the sandals were less popular, but they spent more time. So maybe we were interested to see what happened in the sandal section. So I can just highlight or lasso the sandals over there, and then we can, you know, slice and dice the data any way we want to. We could see that 2 o'clock was more relevant than 1 o'clock. More people visited what happened at 2 o'clock, and so the dashboards will change instantaneously for those powers that be, perhaps the C-level, who want to analyze what people are, what is happening in the store. And I want to stress one thing. We're not talking about moving cameras or having dedicated cameras for this analysis. We're talking about leveraging the existing video surveillance ecosystem that is already in place, already working with the Milestone Expert Tech client, and for having other stakeholders leverage the value that is can be extracted from the video data that's already being recorded. Okay, maybe one more example. Let me just take that back to where it was. One more example. So we could look at one more. Here's quite an interesting example. BriefCam also have the ability inside our dashboard. We can actually import data, POS data or other data, into our BI tool, into our research module. And then we can also understand, we can correlate the data. So we here we have, on the one hand, we have the amount of people. So we have 1,500 people here versus $10,500 of hourly sales. And over here in this chart over here, we have the amount of shoppers versus the amount of employees at the time. What interests me was here, for example, we have almost the same amount of shoppers in the store with $38,000 of sales compared to with at least 25 employees at the time. And here we have a very similar amount of shoppers at the time with almost one-fourth the amount of sales because, and this is the question, maybe where one wants to understand and get insights from this data, with only 20 employees. Now, I'm sure that the lunchtime had some kind of effect on the result, but it begs the question, does the delta of 5 employees have such a huge impact in the amount of sales when the same amount of employees are entering? And this is the type of data that can be derived and understood by fusing BriefCam and other data points like POS software, for example. Just to take you back to, I think that's in terms of the examples. This is what I wanted to share with you today on those three areas. I just obviously want to mention that you know time is very limited and we're just scratching the surface. And obviously for more information, you know, either through Milestone or with us, we can obviously share a lot more information for you. In terms of transportation, of course, we work at some very, very large airports in the world. I couldn't share some examples with you today, but whether it's airports or trains or buses, this is obviously very important for traffic analysis, and we can also deal with that as well. I'll just hop back to the presentation just for one more slide just to end off. Then obviously our relationship with Milestone, as you know, has been very, very successful for the past decade. And as you saw BriefCam now with inside the Milestone Protect client, we intend to go deeper in terms of integration, more capabilities from inside the Milestone Expert Tech client. And also for the partners out there, we're looking at different form factors, different platforms in order to be able to sell BriefCam in a much easier fashion, either on premise today, which we do, but it could either be with appliances, which we will be providing SKUs for appliances, which are certified by BriefCam, and also cloud solutions, which will be coming out in the very near future. And maybe your flavor is a hybrid solution, some on cloud and some on premise, maybe the metadata in the cloud or the other way around. So we're very, very excited about the next chapter. And yes, I thank you very much for your time, and I'll hand it back over to Patrick. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Warren. Thank you. Very good walkthrough of the different possibilities. I hope everyone enjoyed that. Now we are quickly reaching the end of the webinar, but in case that you want to learn more about BriefCam and how it integrates to Milestone, then as Haider also mentioned, you can find more information in Milestone's marketplace. Put the link here for you to take a look. We can also offer you a customized one-to-one demo of the solution. And in case you're interested in this, then please write to Haider. I've his email address here on the screen. And let's see how we're doing for time. We do have a few minutes left, so we take a few questions. Let's take a look here. All right, so there is a question here on product compatibility. Is BriefCam Milestone integration supported for all Milestone products. Haider, is this something you can give an answer to?
Yeah. Right. So BriefCam is integrated with all the Plus product portfolio and also with the export and corporate. So also with the professional, and that can start back from 2017 version onwards. So yes, pretty much all of Milestone product portfolio is integrated, seamlessly integrated with BriefCam.
All right, fantastic. And here's one also for you, I think, and that is there any charge for this integration? Do we require any integration license other than the standard product license?
The Milestone integration platform, we call it MIP SDK, is absolutely free of charge for anyone to use it. You can even register on our website and download our MIP SDK, which is used for these integrations. The APIs that I mentioned in my slide as well. There's no charge at all for this integration. So you get the plugin, which is developed to integrate Milestone with BriefCam. There is no charge involved. So integration is actually free of charge, but obviously there is a license cost for the cameras that you're using on the platform and the capabilities that you want to run on BriefCam. But integration is absolutely free of charge.
All right, fantastic. And then there's a lot of people here also asking if they can get a copy of today's recording. And yes, as I mentioned in the beginning, we will be making this available to you. You receive that via email, so you have that. And in case you have any more questions, please engage with our team. And I think that we are running out of time here. So I want to thank everyone for tuning in. I hope you found it useful and look forward to seeing you again on another webinar in the future. Thank you very much and bye for now, everyone.